Nintendo had the first Splatoon 2 Global Test Fire not long ago, and folks got to try out the game. The Global Test Fire is generally like a free demo, where people can get a peek at the game, and I imagine gives Nintendo a lot of real-time data, and a chance to see the game perform online, in a sort of practice run before the game is completed. Honestly, it's a great idea, and while I'm usually cold on concepts like early access games, these Global Test Fires are so limited that it feels more like a proper demo. But it's also free. Strange to think that for a time, that was normal. I thoroughly enjoyed the first Splatoon, and put mountains of hours into it. Were there not a second Splatoon coming out, I would highly recommend people pick it up. Nintendo later rolled out more maps, gear, and weapons for the online multiplayer. It also had a strong single-player campaign, which offered more than I've come to expect of modern shooters with a focus on multiplayer. The Splattershot, Inkroller, and Charger work like they did in the first game, but the special moves have been changed. The Splattershot gives the player an ink missile artillery they can lock onto enemy inklings with. The Roller allows the player to do a sort of ground pound that covers the area in ink and destroys opponents. And the Charger turns into a constant high-pressure cannon that feels like a slow-moving anime laser. The Splat Dualies are a new addition and seem to be a rapid-fire weapon in the vein of the Splattershot Jr. Dualies allow the player to do two combat rolls as they fire, and the special is sort of a double inkjet rocket pack that allows the player to fly around and shoot high-damage projectiles. Despite enjoying what I played in Splatoon's Global Test Fire, I don't think I'll be buying it. My biggest dilemma is a rare one, and it's something I've only run into with another game, Animal Crossing New Leaf. With either title, this conundrum is a matter of being given a game with so much replay value, I don't want to buy the sequel. Prior to Animal Crossing New Leaf, I had owned Animal Crossing Wild World on the DS. I was lukewarm about it, but New Leaf brought so much new functionality that I decided to give it a try. The Animal Crossing experience was so vastly improved upon with New Leaf that I sunk hour upon hour into catching fish and bugs, working on designs, decorating and improving my home and town, and just playing around with the new features. Just late last year, they even released a free update called the Welcome Amiibo that added more features. That's a free update 4 years after the game first came out. Were Nintendo to release a new Animal Crossing, though, I would pass. I spent so much time playing New Leaf that even if a sequel were to be improved upon, I'd be hesitant to do it all over again. Splatoon has no shortage of replay value and room for player investment. There's ranked battles where players can compete in bracketed matches and get ranked by their wins and losses. There's player levels, which are a way to gauge progress in multiplayer and dole out unlockables, such as weapons and gear. Then there's the part that's really hard to recreate, and that is rolling and rerolling abilities on gear. Since it's all a matter of a random number generator, a lot of Super Sea Snails, or pay 30,000 coins. Coordinating gear with the right abilities is no small task. If going into Splatoon 2 meant that I had to do it all over again, I wouldn't want to climb the ranks, unlock all the gear, and then roll, re-roll, re-roll, and roll again all of my gear abilities. I feel pretty confident that Splatoon 2 will be a good game, if it builds upon what Splatoon did. It will probably even be a better game, but throwing all the progress and time invested away doesn't sound worth it. It's not enough to blow the budget on marketing and plaster advertisements around in the hopes people will pick the game up. Making players feel invested enough to stick with the game is just as important, since it's become common practice for consumers to trade in their titles to less reputable stores. Reggie Fils-Aimé has said that if we build great content, then the consumer will not want to trade in our games. I guess in this case, and at least for me, Nintendo did it a little too well. So if anyone from Nintendo is watching this, please take this into consideration. Only reason I would consider Splatoon 2 is if all my progress was carried over from the first game. I'm not sure how much of Splatoon's multiplayer data is stored locally, but I know at least a little is tracked with their servers. Nintendo's track record with online is shaky, and I'm skeptical if they would be able to transfer that information. Alternatively, Nintendo could do some sort of data transfer, since they have done that with their consoles in the past. Though, it's not terribly convenient. Whether I pick up Splatoon 2 or not, I hope it does well, and that anyone who wasn't familiar with the first game gives it a try. Hopefully, my ideas of the player's progress carrying over are something Nintendo's design team already had in mind. Take care. Until next time.